Get straight to it. Come on, tell them one more time. Let's get straight. And you can turn a little bit of it back. There we go. That's perfect right there. Amen. Turn with me to John, the 12th chapter. Turn with me to John, the 12th chapter. You all, and I have something very important that I want to give to you all today. When you have it, say amen. We're going to wait for a few people to get it. John, the 12th chapter. John, the 12th chapter. Now, some of y'all right now, your mind is already going to the food things. I'm looking for the delicacies that will be after you leave here today. But I want to give you a delicacy in the spirit, in the supernatural. I promise you that will feed you, that will encourage you, and that will give you more wisdom and insight as to what God is saying right now. Amen? So when you have it, John, the 12th chapter, say amen.
Amen.
Okay. Now, you know, traditionally, when I was growing up, whenever this time of year would come around, we would be taught about the death, the burial, and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. We would be taught about how he loved us. We will be taught about how he sacrificed his life for us and how he died on the cross and rose again. How many of y'all heard them stories before?
Yeah.
Just by a show of hands, how many of y'all heard them stories before? Okay, so y'all kind of know where I'm going today, huh? Huh? But you don't. Now, what I want to do today is I want to present some of those same facts in a different manner with the purpose of you leaving here questioning every moment and all of the time you've spent thus far on this earth. Let me say that again. I want you to leave here today and I want you to question every moment and all of the time you spent here on this earth. Anybody ever ask themselves, what was I put on this earth for? How many of y'all ever ask themselves? See, when people ask themselves those questions, that's a question of purpose. That's a question of character to show who you are and where you're trying to get to. Y'all listen, never wake up in a day and just let the day just go by. Never wake up and allow the day to just come to you. You got to get into the habit of taking charge and controlling the day. So John, the 12th chapter, verses 23 through 27. Y'all know how we do it at Faith on Fire. I'm gonna give some exercises to make sure that y'all follow with me today. Are you following with me today? Okay, I'm going to give some exercises to see if you're in the Word. So if you don't have your physical Bible open, I want you to pay attention to the screen. Amen. We're reading out the New King James Version. And I'm not going to be before you long. Y'all like to hear that, huh? I'm not going to be before you long. But Jesus answered them saying, "The hour has come that the Son of Man should be put to death." Okay, so y'all paying attention. Okay, so the hour has come where the Son of Man should be put to death. Oh my goodness. He says the hour has come that the Son of Man should be glorified. Y'all, look at already. Look at how Jesus is viewing death. He's viewing it as glorification. The hour has come that the Son of Man should be put to death. No, right? What's the scripture say? The hour has come that the Son of Man should what? Be glorified. Tell your neighbor, it's how you're looking at it. It's how you're looking at it. Go ahead, tell somebody. It's how you're looking at it. It's how you're looking at it. It's how you're looking at it. You're looking at it as death. God says, I'm looking at it as glorification. See, let me tell you something. This spiritual walk gets hard when you keep looking at spiritual things in a natural manner. Everything that happens in your life, we look at it through natural eyes. I mean, if the family mad at you, you question your purpose here on earth. If your friends don't like it, you question your purpose here on earth. Why do we need everybody to hit our like button so if you have in the spirit for us to be motivated about the things of God? How come we can't have people that's going to follow God no matter what somebody say, like it or don't like it? Because it's in the way that you're looking at it. So Jesus answered them saying, "The hour has come that the Son of Man should be glorified. Most assuredly, I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains alone. But if it dies, it does what?" Wait a minute. Unless a grain of wheat falls to the ground and what? Dies. it remains alone. But if it dies, it what? Produces much grain. He who loves his life will what? Lose it. And he who hates his life in this world will keep it for eternal life. If anyone serves me, let him do what? Follow me. How many of y'all want to serve Jesus Christ? Come on, let me see, just by a show of hands. How many of y'all? Okay, how many of y'all going to follow? We're going to follow today. Okay, well, by the end of the day, I'm going to see if you're going to follow. And where I am, there my servant will be also. If anyone serves me, him my Father will honor. Let me say that again. If anyone serves me, him, meaning the person who serves Jesus Christ, my Father will honor. So I want to talk to you from the subject today of you got to die in order to live. Come on, look at your neighbor and tell him, you got to die in order to live. Come on, look at somebody else and tell him, you got to die in order to live. You come on, one more time for the Holy Ghost. You got to die in order, woman of God, you got to die in order to live. Prophet Michelle, you got to die. Tiffany, you got to die. Prophet Michelle said, kill me. Prophet Michelle just said, kill me now. You got to die. Man of God, Minister Jamal, you got to die in order to live. Because the scripture says, if the seed does not die, it remains alone. But once it dies, it produces much grain. See, for far too long and for too many people, the death, the burial, and the resurrection of Jesus Christ has been overshadowed by the traditions of men in an attempt to rob you of the power that comes with believing that story. For too many years, for far too long, and too many people, because of the traditions of men, have been robbed of the power of the death, burial, and the resurrection. Y'all, they have equated it with the Easter Bunny. But we ain't going there today. We heard those Easter Bunny. We ain't even going there today. We're not going on Easter Bunny. We're not going on chocolate eggs. We're not going on none of that. I'm talking about the power. How many of y'all know there's power in belief? How many of y'all know there is? Listen, when you believe something, there is power behind what you believe. Because what you believe will cause you to act. If you don't believe the stove is hot, turn the aisle, wait for the clicks, wait for you to see the fire, and put your hand on it, and that fire is going to do what? It's going to make you a believer. So you ain't got to question that no more, because you've engaged it. There's power in belief, and what the devil has done is, he don't want us connected with the power behind the death, burial, and the resurrection. Yo, Resurrection Sunday is about suits, clothes, food, and family members. I said this last year. It's become the family reunion of the church. We all got, y'all know what we're going to do after this. Some of us texting right now. What time is it getting out? He just started. He about to go. Come on, y'all. Don't do that. Look at your neighbor and tell him, don't do that today. Don't, listen, say today. Listen, say today you need some power. Say listen, didn't you eat yesterday? That's what my father always tells me. I say, Pops, I'm hungry. He said, T, didn't you eat yesterday? I never got it. He was paying for it. See, I did eat yesterday. Y'all listen, that food ain't going nowhere. Them yet, whatever you eat, beans, greens, but none of that, that's going nowhere. I ain't going to go into it. That's going nowhere. Today, you need power. God has summoned you today so that you can walk with power. We're going to get into it. See, the devil knows that if he can get you to not really believe, that he can cause you to forfeit the power that God wants to give you. See, listen, y'all know why people aren't bringing droves of people into the body of Christ anymore? You know why there is no real manifestation of healing? You know why when you can't save, when you got saved, it's so hard to go and get all your family members? It's because people don't believe in the power. Because if you believe in the power, you'll preach the power. When you get your credit right, what you talking about all day? Oh, listen, I can't stand people with their credit right. Because that's all they want to talk about. Oh, because you know my credit, you know, because I'm a 750, I'm an 800. Y'all know some people that like to brag. I see some people smiling so hard. Listen, they believe in the power of their credit score. Watch this. They walk into dealerships. They walk into mortgage offices. They walk into loan places expecting to get what they ask for because they know the power of that credit score. See, listen, in the supernatural, people ain't walking around expecting but they don't believe in the power. Waking up on a Sunday, not even giving the Lord thanks for being here today. Waking up on Resurrection Sunday, and the whole conversation is talking about Easter. I asked Taylor last night, I said, did you know Jesus died? She said, Jesus never died. I said, Taylor, I got to teach you about the power. I said, Taylor, what is Easter? Oh, Taylor know all of them. But when I asked her about the resurrection, now even though she's 5, she couldn't really comprehend it. But y'all, I'm telling you, there's some people sitting in this audience right now, 40 years old, 35 years old. Watch this. See, we keep thinking, see, this is my thing. We keep thinking that all these experiences of God trying to introduce us to the power, trying to connect us to the right people, it's just by happenstance. You keep thinking every time somebody invites you to church, it's just because they want to be nice. You keep thinking every time somebody invites you to church, it's just because they want their ministry to grow. You keep thinking every time somebody invites you to church, it's so they can fulfill their agenda. When I invite you to church, I want you to get the same power that I got. Well, you say, Pastor, what kind of power are you talking about? I'm talking about the power to leave that old lifestyle and walk for Christ. I'm talking about the power to be a cheater before marriage. Clear it up for the wife. I'm talking about the power to be a cheater and stop it before Christ. I'm talking about the power to stop selling drugs. I'm talking about the power to navigate me away from being nothing into who I am today. Listen, y'all, I don't want you to come to church because I want you to pay your tithes and your offering. This God's house. God don't build his house. As Dr. Ivy Hill said, I got my house. And I got a couple cars. I want you to get this because the same power that saved me, the same power that changed my family from my grandfather all the way down, is the same power that he's trying to give to you today. This ain't about Easter. This is about resurrection power. Look at your neighbor and tell him, resurrection power. Say it one more time, resurrection power. So then you got to ask yourself, what kind of power does God want to give me? Turn with me to Mark the 16th chapter, verse 9. Mark the 16th chapter, verse 9. When you have it, say amen. Mark the 16th chapter, verse 9. First lady, can you please give me a drink of water? Give me a Holy Ghost glass. Amen. Mark 16, 9. You follow me? Now when he rose late at night on the left, huh? Early. Oh, he rose early. So how many of y'all want to be like Jesus? Amen. So the scriptures say Jesus rose early. Scriptures say Jesus rose early. On the first day of the week. Read on. He appeared first to Mary Magdalene, out of whom he cast out 7 demons. She went and told those who had been with him as they mourned and wept. And when they heard that he was alive and had been seen by her, they did not believe. Look at your neighbor and tell them they did not believe.
They did not believe.
After that, he appeared in another form to 2 of them as they walked and went into the country. And they went and told it to the rest. But what? They did not believe them either. Look at your neighbor and tell them they did not believe.
They did not believe.
Later, he appeared to the 11 as they sat at the table, and he rebuked their unbelief and their hardness of heart because they did not believe those who had seen him after he was risen. So here, Jesus is showing himself in full manifestation of God's resurrection power, and he sends people that have seen him, follow me, he sends people that have seen him to do what? To tell the others. These people saying, we've seen Jesus. And guess what? People still don't believe. And Jesus gets to the point where he has to rebuke their unbelief and their hardness of heart because he knows that unbelief is the thing that will stop them from walking in God's power. Y'all, you got to watch that unbelief. Look at your neighbor and tell him, watch that unbelief. Oh my God. Listen, once a person stops believing,